Jumbo, boys and girls. My name is Sylvia Soumah, and welcome to Literacy Through Art. Today, I'm going to share with you a very, very special book. I love books. I love to read. This book is called Alphabet Movers, right? I know you all know your ABCs, right? Sure you do, but there's many ways to learn your ABCs, but we're going to learn your ABCs through movement. But before we get started, I want to introduce you to a very, very special friend.
Hello, I'm Baba Dwayne, and the drum I'm playing today is called a djembe.
Thank you so much, Baba Dwayne. And now, let's build letters with our bodies. Hit it, Baba Dwayne. March in place, and march. Oh, you guys are looking good, yes. Come on, stand up. There you go, and clap your hands. Get that steady beat going. Now we're gonna take the head going down, and up, and down. And down. This means yes, of course. Now, how do we say no? Good job. See, this is a dance exercise. How do you say I don't know with my shoulders, right? Good job. All right. Now we're gonna roll those shoulders. Row, row, row your boat gently down the stream. Go forward. Merrily, 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 life is what a dream. Now, you can sing and dance at the same time, right? That was pretty good. All right, roll the hands and roll. Good job. Now, shake it out. We're getting ready to build those letters. If your name starts with a G, or even if it doesn't start with a G, make the letter G with me. Oh, that's beautiful. Oh, that's looking good. How about the letter T? Awesome. How about the letter L? For love. We need a lot of love, don't we? Yes. How about the letter O? Good job. Or O, nice. How about the letter W? Nice. How about the letter P? Everybody march in pace. March, 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 march. Good. And bring your hands up. And one, two, three, and rest. Good job. You guys did a great job. I got another song for you, right? People sing their ABCs in many, many different ways, right? We usually sing it like this. We're gonna do a little go-go rhythm with it. Are you ready? Here we go. We got A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, and Z. Now you know your ABCs. Next time, won't you sing with me? All right, you know that go-go rhythm comes from DC, right? We did that, the letter G from DC, go-go. We're gonna do another song. ABC song is from Ghana, West Africa. It's called Panlogo ABCs. Now, you can use whatever, instruments you have at home. If you have professional instruments, that's great, but you can use just a margarine container, or you can use a cup, anything plastic with that makes a circular shape like this, and you're gonna play your drum. We're gonna do two beats, all right? I'm gonna say Panlogo, are you ready? And you're gonna give me two beats. How many beats? Two. Panlogo, are you ready? Panlogo, are you ready? Panlogo, are you ready? Panlogo, are you ready? Now we're gonna do a little math here, okay? So I said you're gonna give me two beats after I say, are you ready? You're gonna give me five beats after I say, everybody stop and listen. Everybody stop and listen. One, two, three, four, five. 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 Now you notice it was call or response. The drummer gives the call, we give the response. He plays the rhythm. All right? Now you're gonna give me that steady beat, right? That steady beat like your heartbeat. Steady beat, steady beat. Let me hear that steady beat. Steady beat, steady beat. Let me hear that steady beat. Now you're gonna repeat after me. All right? I say A, B, C, D. You say
A, B, C, D.
I say E, F, G, H. You say
E, F, G, H.
I say I, J, K, L. You say M and N O P. You say M and N O P. Pandogo, are you ready? Pandogo, are you ready? Pandogo, are you ready? Everybody stop and listen. We play. Ah, he tricked us. Yes. We got Q, R, S, T. You say?
Q, R, S, T.
I say U, V, W. You say?
U, V, W.
I say X, Y, and Z. You say?
X, Y, and Z.
My logo, A, B, C.
My logo, A, B, C.
Beautiful, Baba. Logo, are you ready? My logo, are you ready? My logo, are you ready? Everybody stop and listen. I play. You play. Yes. What's up, what's up? Yeah. Excellent. You guys are such great musicians. Remember, alphabet movers. You can make letters with your body, but now you're going to go straight to Auntie Lisa. Are you ready? And you're going to learn how to build letters. Thank you so much, and we'll see you soon.
Hi, I'm Lisa, and I'm so happy you're here with me today to practice building letters and words. I know you had a fabulous time with Mama Sylvia as she shared this amazing book, Alphabet Movers, and you got a chance to move your body in the shape of many of the letters of the alphabet. Letters are so important. They have their own special names and their own special sounds, and when we put them together, we can create words. Words that we can say, words that we can write, words that we can read. I'd like you to take a look at my board. Do you know what the words are that I have on this board? I'm gonna give you some clues. Take a look at my pictures, because good readers use pictures to help them figure out words they don't know. Or you could take a look at the first letter of each of these words. Maybe you know the beginning sound. That can help you figure out the word. Or I'll give you one more clue. Take a look at the pictures. This is a city where many of our friends either live or they live close by. Did you guess that my word says Washington, D.C.? Both the top word and the bottom word are actually the same. The top word is written in all capital or uppercase letters. The bottom word only uses that uppercase W, because it's the first letter in that word. Mama Sylvia taught you how to use your body to make many of the letters of the alphabet. I'd like to teach you how to sign some of the letters of the alphabet and use your hand. The first letter we're going to try is the letter W. Try that with me. Oh, you've got this. That looks wonderful. Now let's try the letter A. Terrific. Good job with signing the A. How about that letter H? Can you do that with me? Wonderful. Good job. Now let's try the letter N. Fold those two fingers over for the letter N. That's excellent. And the last letter we're going to sign is the letter T. So stick that thumb through for the T. Wow, you're really good at signing letters. I'd like to sign to you, great job. Try that with me, ready? Great job, wonderful. Now I'd like to invite you over to my construction zone. And while I'm here, because we're gonna do some building, I'm gonna put on my hard hat. I brought my toolkit with me and I want to share some tools. If I were going to build a house, I may need something like a hammer, or maybe I need a saw, or perhaps I may even need to use a wrench. Excellent. But today in my toolbox, I brought a different type of tools because we are going to build letters that are made from straight lines. And I'd like to show you some of the types of tools that you could use. I'm hoping that you have some of these tools around your house and that a grown-up or someone who's in your house can help you find some of them. Regardless of what kind of tools you choose for your straight line building, you'll need four of each. You may have something like crayons to use. They're straight lines, and you could use those for building. I found some twigs while I was walking. Now, you have to remember, you can pick up things from the ground, but you don't ever want to break anything from a tree or a bush. That could hurt the living thing. I had paint brushes. I could use those because they're straight lines. I could use straws. They're straight lines. I can use markers. Or if you like, you may have pencils, or you can even cut strips of paper. If you need a few minutes to get your building tools, you can put this on pause. I'd like to share with you some of the ways that you can actually build letters, and I'm going to use my building tools to demonstrate that. Perhaps I want to build the letter T. I can do a straight line down and a line across. Maybe I want to try to build the letter A. How about if I take two straws and put them at an angle and then take another straw and put it across? I've made the letter A. Maybe I'd like to try the letter N now. So you're gonna need three of your straight line building tools. I'm gonna go straight line down. I'm going to do a slight slant. So I'm gonna come up to the top here. And then I'm gonna go back up and I have created the letter N. So if you've got your building tools, let's get started. We're going to begin with the letter T. I've chosen some of the letters in the word Washington. I'm going to do a straight line down and then a line across. Use your building tools and try that with me now. Straight line down, line across. Excellent. That was a great job with that. So let's clear the space and let's try another one. This time, we're going to build the letter. Did you guess that it was an H? Good for you. So I'm going to put this up so we can copy it. And I'm going to do a straight line down, another straight line down, and I'm going to spread them apart a little bit. And then I'm going to do a line across. I've just built the letter H. How did you do? Give me a thumbs up if you think you did a great job. Wonderful. I see you've really got the hang of this. Let's now try another letter. This time, we're going to build the letter A. So I'm going to do a slanted line. It's still straight, but it's going to be a little bit of a slant. Another slanted line again, and then I'm going to come across. to create the letter A. Did you do that? Good, give yourselves a pat on the back. You are wonderful letter builders. Now let's try that letter N. You're gonna need three of your straight line building tools. You're going to do a straight line down. You're going to do a slanted line and then another line down. Yes, we've made the letter N. Let's try the letter W. W is the first letter in the word Washington. So I'm gonna put this up for us to copy. And we're gonna do a lot of up and down and up and down for the letter W. So I'm gonna start with a slanted line. I'm then gonna come back to the bottom and slant up. I'm gonna go up to the top and slant down. And then I'm coming back to the bottom and I'm going to slant up. And we just built the letter W. You are amazing letter builders and I'm so proud of you. Again, let's sign. Great job, everybody. Wonderful. Now, I'd like you to come back with me, okay? And for some of our back to the board with our word Washington, and we're going to use some of the letters to create words. Now, if you have paper and pencil or a whiteboard or something that you can write on, you can write the words as well. So I'm going to begin with the uppercase I. And when I put that all by itself, it creates the word I. So if you know that letter, you can already read. You're reading the word I. Let's try another one. I'm gonna take down the uppercase A. If you know the letter A, then you can read the word A. So you're already reading two words. Good for you. Let's try a few others. I'm gonna build another word. I'm gonna start by using my lowercase I, and I'm going to add the letter S. And when I do that and put them together, I've created the word, you're right, is. Good for you, excellent. I'm gonna put my I back, and I'm going to return my S. And this time I'm going to bring down my lowercase t and my lowercase o. And when I put these two letters together, I've built the word two. Now, this time I'm going to build a word with three letters, a lowercase h, a lowercase a, and a lowercase t. And when I put all three together and blend them, I've built the word hat. Nice. And now, this is a little tricky, but I think you can do it. I'm going to use the W, I'm going to use the A, and I'm going to use the S. Now, this doesn't sound exactly the way it's spelled, but the word is was. You did an amazing job with building letters and words with me. Perhaps you would like to challenge yourself by taking these words and writing sentences with them. Maybe you'd even like to write three or four sentences and create a paragraph. Maybe your very own story. Thank you so much for being with me today. Again, I want to sign you did a great job. But before I leave you, I want to teach you a cheer. Just like Mama and Sylvia taught you about call and response, my cheer is also a call and response. I'm going to hold up a letter. I'm going to say its name and its sound. And when I put my megaphone to my ear, I want you to repeat that. Megaphone, it helps me to project my voice. You may not have a megaphone at home, but you can create your own megaphone by simply putting both hands in front of you. Let's give it a try. Are you ready? Give me a W. Whoa. Oh, I hear you. That was great. Give me an A. Ah. Fabulous. You are great cheerleaders. Give me an H. Oh, that was wonderful. Give me an N. Mm. Super. Give me a T. Tuh. I have to sign one more time. You did a great job. Try that with me. Great job. Thank you so much again for being with me, and I hope you had a wonderful time. But don't go away, because Carla's now going to teach you how to make your very own alphabet toolbox. Bye-bye.
Hi, it's great to see you. My name's Carla, and I know you had a great time with Mama Sylvia, Brother Dwayne, and Sister Lisa. You can make your own alphabet scope really easily. Just take a paper tube and cover it some very attractive paper, and then you can really focus in on letters or people or anything that you want to identify. I'm here to teach you a great arts and crafts project. This one's fun and easy, and so is this one. This is how you can make your own toolkit like Miss Lisa had. Now you might say, well, why do I need a toolkit? I'm going to tell you why. Because when you are ready to write or make any art project, the worst part is trying to find your supplies. So if you have your own toolkit or own toolbox, you can keep all your supplies in there. And you'll be so organized, you'll be looking for your colored pencils, they'll be right there. You'll be maybe looking for your markers, and they'll be right there. Or how about these? Yeah, your crayons. Or your glue stick. Things to write with, your pens, your pencils, your markers. And I'm gonna need for this project a pair of scissors and a one-hole punch. But if you don't have a one-hole punch, don't worry about it, because I'm sure you can find a nail or a screw at your house somewhere, and that will work also. Any of the supplies that you see here that I have in my toolbox, I have bought them in a store that's a dollar store. And they are so inexpensive that you can get great supplies at a dollar store. And many of the supplies you already have at home. So when you're choosing a box that's going to be your toolbox, you can just get a box from your house that somebody would throw away, like these three boxes. Well, I've decided that I really like the tissue box. It's the best size for me. So let's use this one to make our box. Take your scissors and just cut it from where that opening is for the tissues and cut it to the corner. And then fold it down. And then take the other side and cut it to the corner. Now, as you can see on mine, I put a little sign. So if you want to put a sign, fold it up, fold the other corners down, take the cellophane off of it, and then we're going to put another piece of paper, and I'm using cardstock for mine, and we can just glue it right onto there with our glue stick, and then we'll have a sign. And if you don't want it to be that big, what do? You just cut it down a little bit. So I'm going to glue that on there. And I don't want it to be so tall, so I am going to cut it down a little bit. And the best way to cut it is to fold it so you'll have a line that you can follow. And we'll put it in there. And that'll be my top. And of course, you can write anything you want on there. The sides, we can also glue down. Or you can tape them down. Or you could also use a stapler. Anything will work. The next thing we're going to do is we're going to put a hole in it. I'm going to use the hole punch and just halfway between there and the other side, same thing. And then we need a string. Well, you can see mine, I used a shoelace. That makes a great string. But also if you have a scrap of yarn or any kind of rope, it's gonna work. But we're gonna need to use an overhand knot. And if you don't know how to make one, it's real simple. You need the letter X and you need the letter O. And what you do is you take it and you wrap it around your index finger, and the part that's over goes through the back, and you pull it and you have a knot. It's called overhand because the one that is in front, over, has to then go under and through. Why don't you try that? Okay. So you'll be able to practice the overhand knot, and then you'll be ready to put your string in, and you just thread it through one side. The shoelaces work really great because the end already has a nice, firm ending to it. But if you need to do that on your rope or string, just put some tape around there and it'll work too. So I bring it through, I do my overhand knot, and if it's not big enough, you might have to knot it twice. Bring it up, bring it over, decide how long you want that string. I'm gonna bring mine in a little bit more, and then I do the same thing on the other side. I'm gonna put two knots in there, one right on top of the other. Then I would be able to cut that side off. And there we have it. And the only reason it's not balancing is because it doesn't have enough weight in it. So let me put my crayons in it, put my markers back in, put my pencils back in, put my one-hole punch back in. So this toolbox is great. And you'd be able to just decorate it however you want. Now let's look at my toolbox because it already has a decoration on it that allows it to actually be a game. First of all, where are you going to get your letters? Okay, well I decided I was going to cut some out of some red construction paper for this side. And then this side, I drew it and then I painted it. And then this side, I generated those from a computer and I thought it would be really fun to cut them in circles to kind of match the design of the box. And then the ones on the front, where do you think I got these purple ones from? Well, here's a hint. That's right, from a cereal box. You can find letters anywhere. And so cereal boxes work great, but also, that's right, magazines. Look at these great letters. Hey, there's that word Washington. Yeah, because it's the Washingtonian magazine. So you can just look through the magazine for the style and color of letter that you want, and put it right on the front. Also, the newspaper. That's right, the Washington Post. The game is this. Okay, Miss Lisa said the letter A by itself was already a word. So you get 1 point for that one. What if we put the letters A and T together? That would be at. That would give me two words. What if I put A-T-E? What does it spell? That's right. I ate a great breakfast today. So now we have three words. So that's the game. Choose somebody that you want to play with and say, how many words can you make out of just the letters? And you can use a letter twice if you want. Because sometimes we have A, E, I, O, and U, and we use those letters a lot and we call them vowels. The other letters we don't use quite as often, we call them consonants. So I hope that you're really going to have fun with your friends and your letterbox. Keep yourself very organized. Put all of your supplies back in your box so that when you are ready to build your letters, write your paragraphs, write your stories, or do your artwork, you'll have everything you need right there in your toolbox. I want to give some special thanks to our sponsors, Washington Performing Arts, and for Dance Place allowing us to film here at the Hyman M. Perlo Studio, and Friends of Growth and Change LLC. Also to David Dowling, our videographer, and our artists, Sylvia Soumah, Dwayne Smith, Lisa Paul. So bye for now.